Welcome to Ghazali. Today we have with us Professor Werner Sasse. Professor has had a very interesting life. He started as a hippie and landed as a professor. He's from Germany, now lives in Korea. He did his PhD in 12th century Korean language from the Ruhr University in Bochum.
That's right.
He started the Department of Korean Studies in this university and also in the University of Hamburg.
That's right.
And now he heads, he's the chair of cultural anthropology in the University of Hanyang.
Korea,
In Korea. He has written many, many books. He's an expert in Korean culture, and not only in Korean literature, but also in preparing kimchi, because he prepared wonderful kimchi in my house. India and Korea are both Asian countries. Usually when we start discussing about developmental kind of strategies in India, we start comparing India with the Western countries.
Right.
And I feel this two being Asian countries, it is very interesting that we talk about these two countries. Both the countries more or less began together on their path to their destiny.
Mm-hmm.
India was independent from the colonial power in 1947 and Korea in 48, and actually exactly on the same day, 15th of August.
Right.
And these countries began their journey to their destiny. Today, India's Human Development Index is 0.55,
mm-hmm.
and Korea's is 0.09,
mm.
one of the 12th most developed economy in the world.
Right.
Now, tell me, these two countries beginning together, and Korea reaching where it reached, why did it happen?
Well, when I compare those two countries, first I must say, I don't know much about India. It's mm-hmm. very superficial.
Mm-hmm.
So you must correct me on that side.
Okay.
But one of the differences I see is that Korea, the population is one kind of culture.
Mm-hmm.
In India, there's a large diversity.
Mm-hmm.
Another one is India has regional centers which are quite strong,
mm-hmm.
whereas in Korea, historically and today, there is one center from which everything is rayed out, so to speak.
Mm-hmm.
So that is probably one of the important differences. When you want to rule, mm-hmm. it is probably, even in a democracy, better
mm-hmm.
when there is a center
mm-hmm.
from which you rule into the countryside
mm-hmm.
than when you have various centers who always are in competition.
Mm-hmm.
This is one difference. Another difference is, I don't know about the literacy rate in mm-hmm. India,
mm-hmm.
but you have many languages.
We have many, many languages.
So in Korea you have one language and a very high literacy. Practically everybody mm-hmm. reads the same language in the same script.
Mm-hmm.
Now that is another, probably an obstacle for development.
In India, okay.
Then there is, I'm not quite sure here, but my question, since I came to India, which is only the second time now,
mm-hmm.
Watching people's behavior,
mm-hmm.
on the one side, I see they are rooted in some kind of religion. There are many religions here, but people seem to be rooted in whatever religion they are in.
Religion plays a very important role in their lives.
Yes. That's what I suspected.
Mm-hmm.
Now, in Korea, you have traditionally three important religions. One is shamanism,
mm-hmm.
one is Buddhism,
mm-hmm.
and one is, in the development, Christianity.
Mm-hmm.
Now, shamanism does not interfere with modern ideas.
Okay.
Buddhism does not, because Buddhism has to do with the individual.
Yeah.
And actually Christianity, there are many different kinds of Christianities, mm-hmm. but the one that was in Korea came together with social ideas, social mm-hmm. development ideas. Mm-hmm. They brought the first modern schools, they brought the first modern medical places, and so modernization was actually helped
by religion,
by the religion, and also because many people, mainly from America, many missionaries came, they brought technology. And so this worked together. Now, I don't know what...
How much role does religion play in public life in Korea? In politics?
In politics and in social questions, it is very strong. While the Christians always had a strong impact, you know, on politics, American politics is very rooted in religion, isn't it? Compared with, for instance, Europe, many countries like Germany, you know. The religion are a motor for people's behavior, but they're not really guiding it. It's more the social side of these religions which help.
Well, you know, I was in Korea a few times, and another very important factor is when I was having a discussion with the Koreans and asked the same question to one of the professors, he said, in India, you have 1 billion individuals, and in Korea, we have 50 million citizens. Can you elaborate on that?
Yes, it's very, on one side, Koreans are very individual. There's a saying when you have, and this is one side. The other side, they're very group-oriented. There's a joke, when you have two people, you have three clubs. One is one man, the other man, and then they are together in the third one.
Okay.
But they are individual. And that, we must stress that, because many people say Confucianism, no individuality. Forget it. It's very individual people. But they also have a strong sense of belonging to groups. That is your school that you graduated from, your village where you came from, and it goes up to the state. So a Korean, when something happens, he is in different layers, rooted in various groups. And so when the state wants to develop and makes a plan, people follow it. Because it's us. The state is us.
You mentioned that state is sometimes more important than the family.
That's right. Like when we had the Asian crisis, the first Asian crisis around the 80s, remember? When Korea was almost, South Korea was almost broke. And the government and private organizations said, we need to collect the gold we have so we can give that as a security for further loans. People would give even their wedding ring. They would present it. And of course they would be given a slip of paper which said you gave us a ring with that and that worth. But they did not quite know whether they'd ever see that money again.
And did they get it back?
They got it back later,
But this is a wonderful thing, I think, where the state, the economic crisis is bailed out by the people by offering gold.
Yeah, because it's us.
This is a very, very interesting thing. I think a lot of things to learn from this. And you mentioned that education. You talked about mothers outside universities when the children are answering exams, crying, and very tense.
Well, Korea is a very competitive society at the moment, actually to an extent that you can be afraid how much this is positive. So it is very important from which primary school you come, then comes the middle school, and only if you have been in a very good middle school, you come to a good high school, and from there you come to a good university. And you have tests all the time. So Korean students from the time practically of late kindergarten are used to having these tests all the time. And the most important one is the college entrance examination. So when that comes around, the whole nation is paralyzed. They even, last time, I don't know whether they do that all the time, but last year, when the college examination started by 8 o'clock, mm-hmm. all the offices started mm-hmm. by 9, mm-hmm. so the traffic would not be congested when the students go to the universities. Oh.
Of course, here, I mean, this kind of thing happens when the cricket game is going on. With the exams, I think in India, it does happen slowly. People are more and more conscious. Yes. That is very, very interesting.
But
how is the suicide rate amongst the students? Because what is the kind of us feeling killing oneself because one failed, especially in exams? Because in Japan, it is very high.
Well, in Korea, it's very, very high also. Mm-hmm. You have a high suicide rate mm-hmm. Around that time, mm-hmm. and not only of the students, but also among the mothers, actually.
Yes. Okay.
And during the exam time, you see the mothers in front of the closed university gate. Mm-hmm. The Christians would pray, the Buddhists would pray. Mm-hmm. Some mothers, the night before, went to a shaman to hope for good luck. And mm-hmm. it's a craze. I think it's counterproductive.
Okay. I think we will go back a little bit about the group mentality, because recently there was a Korean student who mm-hmm. killed some American students.
Yes.
And then the whole country was ashamed of it.
Yes.
They thought they have done it.
Yes. That is what I'm talking about. The spirit of us and them mm-hmm. extends to people, Koreans outside of Korea. And this mm-hmm. student particularly, mm-hmm. he was born in America. Mm-hmm. He was raised in America. And I told my friends, look, he's an American boy.
Yeah.
And running amok in schools is not part of Korean culture, no. It's part of American culture.
Yeah, yeah.
But still, he said, yes, but he came from Korea.
Yeah. Yeah.
So we are ashamed.
Mm-hmm. No, that's, I think, something to learn again from that, because here, there is so much individual-oriented society here. I mean, it's very difficult to convince a group not to throw even the garbage and things like this. And we don't behave like citizens here.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody is an individual. Even the politicians are more interested about their own bank balances rather than improvement of the society. Mm-hmm. And I think we need to learn a lot from the Koreans in this regard.
And this is a point where I want to correct you. It is not citizen spirit.
Uh-huh.
It is group spirit. Uh-huh. We belong to that group.
Okay.
And when it is on the country level,
mm-hmm.
that's a big group. Mm-hmm. But it also has to do with the lower levels mm-hmm. going down to the village, mm-hmm. going to the individual families.
Mm-hmm. Can you give me an example? Because in Japan,
mm-hmm.
I was talking to somebody and they said, we Japanese have decided to have just one child now.
Mm-hmm.
So that the population is under control.
Mm-hmm.
Now, something like this has happened in Korea, that we Koreans decided that we'll do this and we do this?
Well, there you have a point where it is difficult.
Mm-hmm.
Because we had a one-child mm-hmm. policy,
mm-hmm.
which in the beginning did not work very well. Because mm-hmm. people in the countryside said, look, I need the farmhand.
Mm-hmm.
In the cities, it would be more easy to have this kind of policy. Mm-hmm. But then later it worked. You know why?
Mm-hmm.
Because they changed the tax system. And when you had two children, mm-hmm. you had higher taxes.
Oh.
And that hurts.
Okay. Well, so they did find a way out.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. Well,